Hartbeat and Simon & Schuster Audio present Kiss and Tell, stand-up and stories about love, sex, etc. Hosted by Rachel Bloom and Jay Pharoah, with performances by Chinedu Unaka, Chris Garcia, Sydney Battle, JB Ball, Danielle Perez, Zach Noe Towers, Aisha Alfa, Nate Jackson, Morgan J, Noah Findling and Sydney Steinberg, Ron Taylor, Luke Mones and Alyssa Limperis, the Sklar brothers, Mike Lawrence, Atsuko Okatsuka, and James III.
And Simon and Schuster's new audiobook. We are your hosts. I'm Rachel Bloom. Hello.
I'm Jay Pharoah. How you doing?
What's up?
So what you're going to see over the course of tonight, we have a lineup of some of LA's best comedians, and they're going to tell you stories, they're going to sing songs, they're going to tell jokes, and they're just going to talk about love, dating, sex, and relationships. We're basically telling a love story over the course of an evening. It's beautiful.
Yeah. I know there's going to be a lot of sex talk tonight. You know, Meg Thee Stallion would be proud. You know what I mean?
So tonight we're talking about dating, love, and relationships. So before we get into it, I think we should talk about our own situation, just so we're not up here like throwing shade at people, burying their souls. I have been with my husband for 13 years. Thank you. I was telling Jay backstage, I have had sex with 6 men. I don't know if that's a lot or not a lot, but that's my number.
Nah, that ain't a lot.
I have never had sex with a person who didn't attend NYU. they should really name a dorm after me. And my husband is the only person I've slept with who wasn't specifically in the Tisch School of the Arts. So I've had a very specific style of dick. Very artsy, very flaky.
A flaky dick.
Never heard from the dick again.
Never.
Just flaked off inside me. There was this one guy. remember, I was taught the thing is when you fuck a lot inside the same like social circle, you meet a lot of people who've also fucked those people.
Right.
And I remember talking to this girl, and she's like, "You're gonna go on a date with so and so?" And she's like, "He's gonna put a finger in your butt. It's gonna happen. It'll be the first time it happens for you. But he's not gonna ask. He's gonna put a finger in your butt." And sure enough, he put a finger in my butt. Never happened before. So I put a finger in his butt, which I think had never happened to him before. Because then he went, "Oh, where did you learn that?" And I wanted to be like, "From you. You just did it." So that's my. So I've been with my husband now 13 years. We've been married for 6 years, almost 7 years, and we have a 20 month old daughter. So I'm pretty. Really have. I have very pretty basic bitch like Midwestern values. What's your story?
I've known my mom for 34 years. Do you know what I'm saying? That's she's a very nice lady. You know what I mean? Shout out to Ramona. You know what I mean? Look. I ain't married. I'm not married yet like you. I don't have that. My longest relationship was 4 years.
I mean, I don't want to sell you out, but you brought a woman to this show tonight, and she's in the green room. This is her first time seeing you perform live, I believe.
Yep. It is. It's a good time for her, you know? It's an amazing time for you all as well. And she's going to hear some shocking shit. It's been fun, though. Listen, man, I've had a lot of microwavable relationships, you know what I mean? You know what that is, when you're in there quick, you know, it's like a Hot Pocket. You know, a Hot Pocket, you just put in the hot, and you get rid of it.
I didn't know what that was going to be.
Yeah.
Are you saying that you heat up a Hot Pocket to fuck it?
I mean, listen, look, to each his own. Look, everybody got their way, I got mine. Fuck you for judging, okay? All right.
We're gonna start tonight's show with stories about dating, and so the story of the last date that I went on before I was with my husband, what looks like forever, until one of us dies, probably him because he's a man. Odds are good. He's an older man. He's going to die. So I'm really excited to fuck a lot in like my 70s. You know? I know I'm going to have a couple of years. That's like what makes me like super okay with monogamy, because I know this isn't the end.
Hey, I can follow up. I could listen. I ain't got no problem with no older women. Fuck that. Older women, fuck, turn up. Shit.
Older Are you woman- saying you want to like fuck me in 60 years?
Some see people sometimes a punchline could just be the way you position your body. It don't got to be words.
Which is great for an audiobook.
Yeah. But I'm saying, yo, look, I ain't got no problem with no older goddamn woman. You know what I'm saying? When a woman get over 40 and shit, she got a lingerie closet full of shit. I'm talking about mad shit, nigga. She got goddamn little fuzzy slippers and robes and thigh-high stockings and be coming down the hallway with a glass of brandy in one hand and a life insurance policy in the other one, nigga. Shit's fire, man. That's fire. They know what to do. They cook for your ass afterwards, nigga. You know what I'm saying? That shit is dope. Oh, my God. Yeah. You see what happened to old boy that was dating? He was 34 dating that 73-year-old. You know what I'm talking about? He was dating a chick and shit was fucked. And then on the honeymoon, she died. I said, nigga, you know what you did. You know what I mean? You know what you did, goddamn. You waited for that motherfucker. You weren't interested in goddamn a golden girl. You ain't give a fuck about that shit. You know what I'm saying? Ain't one don't thank you for being a fuck that shit, nigga. You was trying to get that bag, nigga. You was trying to get that fucking bag. You know what I mean? Hey, get your money. Make your motherfucking money. Shit, you know, do what the fuck you got to do. Shout out to Pete Davidson. I got to say that. Hey, let me ask a goddamn question. I know this shit is on everybody's mind because I'm his homeboy and it's on mine. How the fuck? Anybody else? How the fuck? How in the fuck is he doing this? This nigga, his body count is great. I say, he's got one of the most immaculate body counts I have seen in my life. Nigga, he fucked a vampire from the underworld. Are you kidding me? You fuck Kate Beckinsale, Ariana Grande, and now potentially Kim Kardashian.
It's insane.
Nigga, I look up to you. That shit is crazy. Shout out to Pete, man. That's what it is. He got the black lips. That's what it is. Yeah, that's what it is. Hey, black people, don't he look like us right here? He does, okay? That's just what it is, okay? This is gonna be fun as fuck. Keep going, Rachel.
Oh, I was gonna say something, but then I got distracted with you talking about Pete Davidson's black lips.
Oh, Lord, we got a great lineup for you all tonight. Y'all ready to get shit going? You seen him on Insecure Season 5. He'll be in the upcoming House Party reboot. Y'all give it up right now for Chinedu, Unaka!
Yeah, they're trying to communicate better with the opposite sex this year. I've been using more emojis, you know? Emojis can save a relationship. It really can. Cause I got a romantic soul, but I don't want to spend a lot of money every single day. But now because of emojis, every woman I text get roses, flowers, bouquets, chocolate shoes. I'll get you 68 shoes. It costs me nothing, you know? If you're really cool, I'll wake up early and I'll text you breakfast, man. You got to try it, man. They love it. They go to work bragging to their friends. Look at Chinedu. He done woke up early and text me eggs. I put a little fire next to the eggs so she know it's hot. You know? Use emojis, men and women. Get you out of awkward situations. I was dating this one young lady and I really liked her. But I think she got a little tipsy because she texted me she loved me. And we never said it to each other yet in person. But I want to argue or make her feel bad, so I text her back a yellow heart. Because yellow hearts don't mean shit, right? It's like a, right? It's like a get well soon. Good luck with that disease. She texted me a question mark with a gun next to it. I said, hold on, man. I said, purple heart, you know, thank you for your service. But just...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.